Hi Rockstars! Welcome to my channel. This week I was supposed to be revealing the mirror design, but I apparently didn't plan it well. I have started working on it, and I have to confess, this thing is kicking me in the behind, okay? Getting this done, getting the rings done for the mirror was the easy part. The part that's getting me right now is how I will get to make this into a perfect circle and secure it together right here. So I'm still spinning the wheels and trying to figure that out. And I do have some progress to show you, but I do not have the finished product yet, as you can see. So this weekend also happens to be my husband's birthday and our anniversary. So I will, so it just makes it almost impossible for me to be able to actually get some work done. As it turns out, we have no kids this weekend. I have got the shakes, to be honest. This will be the first time in 7 years since we've been married that the kids will not be at home. And we're not going anywhere, but we just have the freedom to just do whatever it is we want, you know? We don't have a curfew, we don't have to rush home for anything. The kids are away on vacation, not really a vacation, they're just away with their cousins and we are home alone. I've got the shakes, okay? I have no clue what to do with myself. I literally made my husband and I go out of the house yesterday just to go keep busy because I don't have kids for the weekend and I feel like the house is too empty and I've got the shakes. Like every time I think about it, my heart skips a beat because I'm like, where are the kids? The house is empty. There is not a sound. It's just me and my husband and I've got the shakes. Isn't that weird? Anyway, so since we have this little bit of freedom, I am actually planning a lot of things for my husband to enjoy his birthday and for us to enjoy our anniversary. So I shan't be working this weekend, unfortunately, and hopefully I'll be able to reveal the mirror next week. In the meantime, enjoy the little progress and how I came about the progress, and next week we will just pick up where I left off here and we'll see where we go. Hi guys, I am gloving it up today. I've got my safety goggles on and I'm ready to start cutting my pine board, which yesterday I actually did a test cut using a smaller piece of scrap pine board that I found in my garage. And I realized that it actually was flexible enough and I already set the width of each strip that I needed and it works perfectly. This is 6 feet and I'm going to be cutting them in increments of, I believe it's 1/8 of an inch, really thin. So I'm just going to get to work and you guys can watch me work. So as you can see, I work in a very small garage and I don't have room for large equipment. This is my brand new skill saw that I just got and I think this is going to be the most use I'm going to get out of it. I had an old one which I used in my other video, but this is going to be my first time really, really using this. So, because I don't have an outfeed table, you can tell right here that I have basically created a method for this board to feed onto that table so I don't have to start worrying about it tipping once the weight goes to the other side. And over here I also have created a jig that will help me hold the weight so I can literally just concentrate on having this flush to the fence. So I'm going to get started and I'm kind of nervous, but I'm not nervous about using the table, just nervous about how this is going to handle on all my jigs and hopefully it doesn't ruin my work. So I'm going to get started and we'll see how that goes.
Hi
Okay, so I'm done cutting the strips. I'm actually soaking them in water right now so I can easily make a circle out of them.
While the strips of wood are soaking, I'm going to start calculating how big the length of each one that I need to cut,
and if I can actually get two uses out of one strip, that'll even be better. And then I need to figure out how I'm also going to put this together. So right now, alright, so here we go. This is going to be the base point of what I'm going to start with. This little base is actually just an hair bigger than the mirror that's going to be sitting on here. So it makes it so much easier for me, and I can literally just start gluing these together as long as I have the right length. And this then becomes my base. This then becomes the base for the design. And then I just have to figure out exactly how to keep it in place, which I believe I have clamps that are big enough to do this. Once I get this in place, then I can start building on this.
So that's it for today. Thank you for watching. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe. And you can also find me on Instagram @BoseRocks. Until next week, bye-bye. Odabo.